Hi everyone, my name is IFEOMA. I work with a pension fund administrator and I'm here today to tell you about a divine encounter I experienced under the ministry of Dr. Antoni Okoh.
IFEOMA was scheduled for a medical surgery to correct a defect in her body. Before the surgery, she met with Dr. Antoni Okoh for prayers for a successful medical procedure.
I was sick and really very ill, and I had seen the doctors and they had recommended that for me to have like a lease in life, I needed to undergo a major surgery. And eventually I made the decision to do that surgery, and I spoke to my pastor about it and he prayed about it and encouraged me. 2 days before the surgery would hold, I came to see him and he prayed for me, and the prayer was weird for me that day because he looked into my eyes, held my head, and at some point I lost it because, you know, the anointing had taken over. And the words I could hear him say was, "I thicken your head with steel against the arrows of the enemies that targeted against you." And he said it, and when he was there, he looked into my eyes and said, "Ifeoma, you'll be fine." 2 days later, I went for the surgery, checked in, fantastic hospital, very experienced surgeon, and they rolled me into the theater, and definitely you'll be unconscious. They did the surgery, it was successful, and they were wheeling me out of the surgical theater when I started bleeding from every outlet in my body.
What was meant to be a simple 4 to 5 minutes procedure became a 2-hour-long emergency medical attention. When she started bleeding out of every opening on her body,
he realized it was an emergency and that there was a need for them to do a second surgery. So in the space of how many hours, something that take people's lives, just one surgery had taken some people's lives, I had to do like two. They were wheeling me back in for a second surgery. At that point in time, my mom, she was there with me. She called my younger brother. My younger brother had to call Pastor Antoni Okoh. Meanwhile, Dr. Antoni had been trying to reach me. My phone was switched off. So by the time my brother put a call across to him, he went into prayers. As God will have it, this narrative was what I heard from third parties, people in church here. As God will have it, that day, he was praying. People started coming to church that day, and then he instructed them to pray. And prayers started going on. And while those prayers were going on, that prayer was very significant because it did a very major thing. Because in the course of the surgical operation, the second one I was doing, the doctor or the surgeon got to a point, he was losing grip. And, you know, based on the testimony shared with my friend who was also there in hospital, he said in his mind, he was telling himself, is this how he's going to lose a patient for the first time in his life, that he was losing grip on things. He didn't know what to do again.
And just when the doctors were giving up on her, thinking this may just be the end, God intervened miraculously. The Bible says, "The thief cometh not, but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy." The plan of the enemy concerning IFEOMA was to terminate and kill her, but hallelujah, just at the nick of time, God showed up and gave Sister IFEOMA life in abundance.
And just then, when he was coming to a point where he was like, "This girl is going," you know, he said he heard a voice. It's really strange, but it's true. He said he heard a voice call his name. Call him. His name is Chevron, Dr. Chevron. Call him 3 times. And the voice started giving him instructions. This man is not a Muslim. He's a Christian, but, you know, he's not a churchgoer. So he said at that point, all he knew to do was to obey the voice that was giving that instruction. He wasn't interested in knowing where it was coming from, but he knew he was hearing a voice speaking to him. And the voice was giving instructions on what to do, and instead carrying out these instructions. And he was doing this, and in church here, prayers were going, people were praying, my pastor was praying, members of the church were praying, and he was doing this thing, going by the instructions. And And that was it. And what had taken how many hours and what I had been battling with, and that was it. And that was how, you know, the surgical procedure was successful, and then everything was stable and everything was normal.
And now, Sister Ifeoma Keshi is completely restored. Hallelujah.
Recovery process wasn't easy. For one thing, I wasn't working very well. I'd lost a lot of weight. So I was trying to gain my weight. My legs were very unstable. I couldn't walk very well. So it took me like 3 months actually. I was at home for 3 months. I wasn't going to walk. I was just trying to get myself through, I was learning how to walk like a baby again. It was difficult. And then I had my battle scars. I call them battle scars because, you know, I had friends that undergone the same surgical operation. 40 minutes, 45 minutes, they were out. But mine took like how many hours? And I did 2 in a day. And I survived it. In fact, for that doctor, it's a miracle. He even told me like he doesn't get it, but it just happened. So Pastor Antoni is a man of God. I don't know how to emphasize it. Pastor hears from God. Pastor is a visionary leader. He has availed himself to be used. He's had his own encounters too. He doesn't mean words when he talks about it too. And I now understand his passion for ministry and how he's been able to, you know, minister successfully to people, healing people. I want to use this opportunity to invite you to the Day of Recovery Lekki edition, scheduled for the 17th of November 2019. It's going to be an awesome time with God, and I'm assuring you that you're going to see the move of God like never before. Our anointed servant of God, I call him our recovery messenger. That's what he's known by. He's going to be there live. He's going to minister to you. And I can assure you that you will never leave there the same. Come and experience God. Come and experience the ministry of Dr. Antoni Okoh. God bless you.
Get ready, Lekki, for your Day of Recovery.
Whatever is behind the barrenness in your life, whatever revelation you need to receive for that change, that breakthrough to come, as you say a loud amen, let that blessing return.
Don't pursue the effect of blessing, because the world will go after it and attack it. Car is not a blessing. House is not a blessing. Money in the bank is not a blessing. It can be attacked. And the world will always attack things that are physical. They attack the dress that Joseph wore. They attack his coat of many colors. They tore it. But they did not know they could not tear his destiny.
Venue, 14 Dreamworld Africana Way, off Kilometer 20 Lekki Epe Expressway, Lagos. Coming up on Sunday, November 17th, 2019. Time, 3 p.m. prompt. Your host, Dr. Antoni Okoh, the Apostle of Recovery.
Hello, my name is Dr. Antoni Okoh, lead pastor of Sovereign World Church. I'm inviting for Day of Recovery. It's a special program meant to bring you to the place of wholeness, a place of healing, and a place of total recovery. Now, the theme of this program is revoke. Question, what are we revoking? A lot of people live in the fear of the unknown. Some have the fear, how will my end be? Some are afraid, with my prosperity, will I be able to sustain it? Some are afraid of debts, evil occurrences, and that's why we're here to revoke it through the power of God. Isaiah 7:7 declares, thus said the Lord, shall not stand, neither will it come to pass. Join us for this unforgettable program, unforgettable experience, coming up on the 17th, 3 p.m. at number 14, Dreamworld Africana Way, Kilometer 20, Lekki Expressway, by Chevron Toll Gate. It's a special program that will affect and change your life. Make it a date with us. It's your Day of Recovery.